The headlines today is that an estimated 18 billion pesos is parked at a little known agency of the DTI called the PITC. So you exposed this, and is it 18 billion?
You know, after looking at the audited financial statement, I suspect that it's over 33 billion. I repeat that. The latest financial statement, as of December 31, 2019, indicates that customers' deposits in PITC is 33.4 billion. Now, assuming that there are also some private sector deposit, which is not much. So you're talking about funds to the tune of 33 billion in government funds deposited in a small trading firm called Philippine International Trading Corporation, and the deposits of their clients grew from a small 4.8 billion in 2015. Suddenly in 2019 it grew to 33.4 billion. So what is happening, Karen, is that government agencies who are supposed to purchase goods, products, would engage the services of this little-known trading agency of government and pass on the budget there, so that they will say, well, that it is already obligated. But in truth and fact, it is just deposited. So several questions arise. Number one, these amounts deposited by government agencies, as I said, ran to 33.4 billion in 2019, and yearly this has grown. So question, who earns, when these parked funds earn interest, is it remitted back to government? Number two, PITC makes profits in its operations. They charge what you call a service fee of anywhere from 1% to 5%. And therefore, they make profits in 2019. It made over 629 million pesos on the basis of the COVA report. How much of that was remitted to the national government, because this is a government agency? Now, what is a little bit worrisome to me is that the agency is being tapped to handle the purchase of COVID-19 vaccines. And the allocation is about, from what we hear, they will be given about 20 billion pesos in deposits at a 1% commission. That's about 700 million. At 4%, that's about, at 20 billion, 1% of that is 200 million. And if you add the other deposits, which are of other agencies, assuming they earn 1% commission, their potential profit is 540 million. This is a small trading company attached to the DTI.
All right. A few questions on PITC. Senator, number one, is it necessary for government agencies to tap the PITC for the purchase of goods that they need? Number one, for example, COVID-19 vaccines. In a government-to-government transaction that was ordered by President Duterte, is it necessary for PITC to get into the picture?
No. In every government agency, they have a procurement service. In fact, the Department of Budget and Management has a procurement service. So I cannot understand why PITC is there, who earns commission from the procuring agency rather than the selling, rather than the one who would sell the packages or the products to the acquiring agency. Ordinarily, in a business transaction where you sell something, you get a commission. In this particular case, the buyer gives the commission to the agent.
Okay. Another question, is it legal for the PITC to get commission on these purchases or sales?
I have been told that they are authorized to collect anywhere from 4% for projects worth 25 million and below, and 1% for projects worth 700 million and above. I have to check this. If this is author, and I understand this has some authority in a presidential decree or in some law or in some regulation, let me check that, but that's what I am told.
Okay. Based on the budget deliberations, the performance of PITC has been quite poor. There have been funds that have been deposited, obligated, and yet delivery of certain goods were not given on time. You've named some of these items, you and Senator Lacson, items from the Philippine Army, Bureau of Fire Protection, so many items that is needed by government, and yet delivery time is poor.
Well, just looking at their financial statements would indicate that indeed delivery is poor. Because since 2015, 5 years, you know, they have their customers' deposit has increased from 4.8 billion in 2015 to 10.9 billion in 2016 to 19.7 billion in 2017 to 30.7 billion in 2018 and 33.4 billion in 2019. It means that this money just stay there. Mm. It keeps on growing every year. So, you know, we talk about the Bureau of Fire Protection. They deposited in PITC $3.27 billion. In 2019 alone, $150 million, more or less. And surprising thing here, apart from fire trucks that was supposed to be purchased through PITC, 242 fire trucks were not delivered. And surprisingly, they are tasked to build fire stations, 98 fire stations, in fact. So the charter of PITC says they are a trading company.
Yeah.
How is it that they are now engaged in the construction of 98 fire stations and they have not delivered? And the PNP in 2016 deposited 1.347 billion for firearms. Only 311 million have been delivered worth of firearms. So, you know, the PITC is a kind of worms. We will investigate this because, you know, the Secretary of Finance and the DOF is really straining to raise funds because of the drop in revenues. And here you are, you know, government agencies depositing with PITC their budget so that it is made to appear to be obligated, when in truth and in fact, it is sleeping in the coffers of PITC. Interest is being earned. And we do not know whether profits are being remitted to the national government. On the basis of the COA report, PITC earned 629 million in profits last year.
And what did they do with the money? Is it stated, Senator?
Good question. I don't know. I don't even know if they have remitted these profits to the national government. I don't know how much they as bonuses and salaries. And here, you know, we have a GCG or which is supposed to monitor the performance of these agencies, the GOCCs. We passed this law, we wrote this law, and that is precisely the purpose of their existence, to monitor the performance of these GOCCs. Obviously, they do not. The GCG is not doing its job, because here suddenly, because of our questions, we discovered that 33 billion in funds are being parked in the coffers of PITC. and we do not know how it is being disposed. It does not pass through Congress. So there is really a valid basis to start looking into the operations of PITC and see, you know, whether we are being shortchanged or worse. If there are commissions running all over the place, you know what commissions are.
But what's interesting, Senator, given the poor track record of PITC, why would agencies still insist to use this agency to actually purchase what they need instead of doing it some other way?
On their own, for example.
Absolutely. Why would any agency, like, for example, the purchase of COVID-19 vaccines, why would the government continue to tap PITC considering the performance has been so poor?
I cannot answer the question. Maybe they are not yet aware of how poor a performance PITC has. And maybe Secretary Dominguez is not aware that there is 33.4 billion pesos parked as of the end of the year in PITC per COA audited reports. That they charge a commission. You know, this is really unfortunate because, I repeat, at a 20% purchase of COVID vaccines, the commission would run to something like 200 million pesos in commissions, in commissions alone. Now, you see, and going into that, you know, the budget only provided for 8 billion for the purchase of COVID-19 vaccines. Now, according to the Department of Health, to achieve herd immunity, 60% of our people must be inoculated. 60%. You, assuming that we have a population of 105 million, just for easy computation, assume that we have to inoculate 60 million Filipinos in order to achieve herd immunity as opined by the DOH. 60 million Filipinos. Now, 60 million Filipinos, the papers today said that the inoculation will cost anywhere from what, $27 to $35?
Yes.
Assuming, just for easy computation again, $20 for inoculating a single Filipino. That's 1,000 pesos.
Yeah.
If you multiply 1,000 pesos by 60 million Filipinos, you're talking about 60 billion just to achieve herd immunity. 60 billion pesos. How much is the allocation? 8 billion pesos in the budget. So, you know, and okay, just to be fair, the inoculation, I estimate, cannot start earlier than the second half of the year. That's most reasonable.
Of 2021, of course.
Of 2021. Yeah. Of 2021. So you talk about the logistics. First, we are an island nation, okay? So you have to establish inoculation centers all over the Philippines to be able to inoculate, say, 30 million first. You know, just
although
as
you
said,
can use the existing health centers, right?
Yes,
because that's a vaccine.
Of course, you can you can use that. But I don't know if you have computed, Karen, the magnitudes that we're talking of to achieve to inoculate 30 million Filipinos. In 6 months' time, you have to inoculate, or immunize, or inoculate, 166,000 Filipinos per day.
Yeah.
Okay, yes. We compute that. 166,000 Filipinos must be inoculated. To have 30 million of our countrymen be inoculated and achieve herd immunity, as so-called herd immunity, as called by the Department of Health,
okay,
of 60 million Filipinos being inoculated.
All right.